I'm a regular attendee of the orchestra's concerts, most recently as Deputy Mayor last Saturday at Chester Cathedral, where I was not alone in being moved to tears of the right sort by their performance of the Vaughan Williams Fantasia on the theme of Thomas Tallis, followed by Elgar's Enigma Variations. I am proud now as Mayor to become the orchestra's patron, and I can give an early notice of their annual summer concert here in this very hall, the last night of the Proms, Best of British programme, on Saturday, 21st of July. I must also thank the Mayor's Secretary, rather Civic Officer, Sue Carroll, for her help and guidance throughout my year as Deputy Mayor. Our attendant Paul, and all the drivers who have delivered us safely to and from the 18 engagements we have completed. I must also thank them and all the staff involved in arranging this occasion. But most of all, I want to thank my predecessor, the outgoing Mayor, Anne, and her consort Bill, for their advice, encouragement and kindness, and for all the varied opportunities they have given us to learn on the job and to gain confidence for the year that lies ahead. Yes, I did say 18 engagements, which is nothing compared with their hundreds. I hope to be allowed to offer the incoming Deputy Mayor similar opportunities. Anne and Bill have been superb ambassadors for Wirral, striving to uphold the dignity, style and importance befitting the mayoralty of this borough. These are things that the Mayoress and I are determined to continue. Now I turn to my charities. Councillor Lewis referred to my involvement with sailing. I suppose the beard is a bit of a giveaway. Sailing came to my family when, as a young man, my father succumbed to hay fever and gave up summer grassroots sports. Sailing is something that he was able to share with me. Well, to be honest, I insisted he did. Yes, that's me and him, taken unawares, on the west foil bank, opposite Hillbury, low water, after the annual Point of Aries, when I was about 9 or 10 years old. He was Commodore of Wallasey Sailing Club soon after I was born, and as you have heard, I followed in his footsteps 40 years later. Happily, I've also been able to share sailing with my own children. Caroline and John, who are both here this evening, not only around our rural coast, but on holidays in the Menai Straits. Several of our competitors in this race, starting opposite Bangor here, next slide please, are also present here this evening. I thank them for their friendship and keen competition. So what fantastic day, what it really was. So what has this all got to do with charities? Well, for those of us who take pleasure in venturing afloat around our coasts, the RNLI is our natural choice, charity of choice. As a peninsula, Wirral is surrounded by tidal water on three sides with an extreme tidal range. Our lifeboat station is Hoy Lake, established in 1803, before the institution itself. West Kirby since 1966, and New Brighton since 1867, house three lifeboats and a hovercraft, which are all crewed, launched and maintained by volunteers from their local communities, and on call 365 days a year, 24/7. The RNLI does not receive any government funding and relies on public support and donations. This is what they do and how they do it. Now operations manager.